There are places hidden on the internet. Dark, forbidden places. Places that people like me go to for information. People like me that are very much aware that something is really wrong with our world. It is in these deep corners one can find certain things, like snatches of scripts, character outlines, drawings, and parts of old YouTube trailers taken down and never to be shown again. All of these things pertain to a kids' show that was created for television, but never aired. It was compiled by a woman who died a few years ago. Her name was Melanie Rose. It was this article I found posted by someone who went by the ID Derpy that drew my attention. And I do confess, I find myself believing in it. Firstly, Derpy had posted other articles and information on the show before, and is generally viewed as a trustworthy source. Secondly, as I myself have worked for Disney for a very short time, I have heard certain rumors about the subject. The article revolved around a ride that was long gone before I was hired on, but the rumors still persist to this day. In the end, I cannot verify nor deny this story. I'm posting her last journal entry here to let the reader decide. Do with it as you wish. My Little Pony, Adventures in Equestria, from the Journal of Melanie Rose.
It was going to be a hot day. The park hadn't opened yet, and I could already feel the beads of sweat rolling down the back of my neck. I was among the crowds of guests waiting to enter the park, and could feel myself growing impatient and nervous. A month ago, I had come here to try and sneak in and see it, but I was caught by security. They were nice to me, as they escorted me through those mysterious tunnels under the park that everyone talks about. They took me to the office of Disney Security, where they took my name and ID. They also told me they were letting me go with a warning. But if they ever caught me again anywhere on Disney World property, I would be arrested for trespassing. I was being banned for life. Yet here I am again, 2 days from now. That secret Disney and Hasbro have been doing their best to pretend doesn't exist will be gone. 2 days from now, what I came all the way here to see will be demolished to make way for some new ride. From what I've heard told, it will be some sort of Snow White roller coaster ride. 2 days from now, the My Little Pony ride will be erased from this earth, never to be seen again. In 2009, Hasbro was in full production with a new cartoon series. It was a planned reboot for one of the old 80s series that didn't do so well when it came out. But they were confident that the new one would make up for the failures of the first. After all, I bet you can't name a little girl who doesn't like ponies. It was spearheaded by a man named Simon Kay, who was very well known in the industry for creating hit cartoon series. Hasbro was so confident in this new series, they teamed up with Disney Parks to create an attraction for it. How it came to be, I can't say. The deal was done behind closed doors, but there are a few things I have learned. The ride was called My Little Pony Adventures Through Equestria. The estimated cost was around $80 million, with royalties paid to Hasbro for their intellectual property, but ultimately owned by the Disney Corporation. The ride itself, some sources have said, was around 5 to 7 minutes long, with a combination of animatronics, 2D animation, and 3D animation. It was something that was described as a mild indoor roller coaster. Upon entering the ride, guests were seated into a gold or silver chariot, representing the sun and moon respectively. Each chariot would hold between 10 to 15 people. When the ride begins, guests would magically teleport from Disney World to Equestria by a purple unicorn named Twilight Sparkle. Twilight escorts the guests throughout her new home of Ponyville, meeting her friends along the way. However, an evil alicorn named Nightmare Moon tries to prevent Twilight and the ride's guests from progressing throughout the ride. She vows to end Equestria with eternal darkness. Twilight tries to stop her with the assistance of friends the riders have just met, and more obstacles are presented. A blue unicorn and something called a Draconiquus named Discord attempt to create chaos and prevent Twilight from stopping Nightmare Moon. However, Twilight Sparkle gains access to some magical gemstones called the Elements of Harmony, and they're able to defeat Nightmare Moon. The ride ends with everyone arriving in Canterlot, the capital city of Equestria, with Princess Celestia thanking Twilight, her friends, and the ride guests, before sending them back to the Magic Kingdom in Disney World. That was what the ride supposedly was about. From what I've learned, the My Little Pony ride was completed, but it never opened. It sits there unused in the Magic Kingdom, hidden by a wooden fence and potted bushes so well that it's easy to miss if you don't know what you're looking for. But my question is, why? What happened? As I researched the television show, I slowly began to realize why Disney would rather take an $80 million loss and pretend it didn't exist. They were scared of it. Finally, after waiting for what felt like hours, the park opens with its flair. I wipe the sweat off my forehead while I navigate my way through the crowd. I feel a little nervous as I pass by Disney employees that welcome me into the park. I have been a lot more cautious on this return trip. I cut my hair short and dyed it red. I am also wearing a sun hat and wearing thick red glasses. With the thousands of people entering the Magic Kingdom every day, I'm sure I won't be noticed. But seeing the park employees makes my gut wrench at the prospect of being caught. I pick up the pace as I make my way through Main Street USA and cut through Cinderella's castle as I exit the other side, entering Fantasyland. The carousel is the first thing that greets me, playing old Disney songs while rows of perfect white horses spin round and round in a circle until the end of time. When I was a little girl, the carousel was my favorite thing in the world. Now, it kind of scares me. I stare at the horses and wonder, what secrets do they know? What are they not telling us? I looking into the eyes of the countless horses as they spin past me, feeling that if they could talk, they would tell me to run.
You're going to die,
came the voice of a little girl as she got into the line for the carousel. I froze, as those words stabbed through my heart. Turning around, I see her. She's 7, maybe 8 years old, wearing a cheaply made yellow ballerina dress that reads, "You have friends in Equestria," on the upper part of it. Attached to the bottom was a pink tutu that matched her long, flowing pink hair. Fake plastic wings were attached to the back of the dress, while her arms wrapped around a purple plush unicorn that seemed to stare at me with those intense blue eyes. Slowly, the carousel began to spin as the wooden horses went up and down with some overplayed Disney music.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch what you said. Can you please repeat that?
I say to her,
Who is your favorite pony?
The girl asked me, showing off her perfect white teeth as she smiled.
Mine is Twilight Sparkle.
Favorite pony from what? The little girl stared at me for a moment, as if she was listening for someone only so that she could hear before she finally spoke again.
They were right. This really is the happiest place on Earth.
I watch as she skips away from me, leaving the line and disappearing into the throngs of people moving all around. I try to catch sight of her, but she's gone, leaving me standing next to the carousel as it plays When You Wish Upon a Star. I hate to admit it, but that little girl shook me up. Picking up the pace, though, I work my way to the edge of where Fantasyland bordered with Liberty Square. That's the location I remember the ride was built. As I said before, the ride has been barricaded by wooden fences too long to see through. obscured even further by potted bushes, shrubs, and some other plants. I have to admit, it is excellently camouflaged. If you didn't know what you were looking for, you would have easily walked right past it. I picked up the pace ever more so as I get closer. Now that I know what I'm looking for, it becomes easier to see as I make a beeline towards it. Carefully, I work my way through the plants. It was easy to find the latch, so I grip the handle and open the door.
Ma'am, what are you doing? You're not supposed to be in there.
I found myself freezing and my mind racing as I heard footsteps of Disney security walking right behind me.
Ma'am, I'm gonna have to ask you to step out of the bushes.
I've never claimed to be a fast thinker, but today seemed to be an exception. As I reached into my purse and pulled out my pack of cigarettes, I jammed one into my mouth, lighting it, as I backed up slowly. "Sorry," I said, giving him the friendly smile I could as I blew a steady stream out of my mouth. "I was just looking for a place to smoke. Someone told me where, but I couldn't find it." Like a true Disney employee, I saw him relax as he directed me to the nearest area, probably figuring me for just some stupid tourist. I pretend to listen to his instructions and then waved as I went my way, breathing a sigh of relief as I turned the corner and out of his vision. I mentally kicked myself for being so careless. I need to pay better attention if I don't want to get caught again. So, I let some time pass, wandering the park until I decide to head back to the spot. Damn it. As I get closer, though, I can see him hovering around the area. He seems bored standing there, but still alert, paying attention to each passerby. Before he can spot me, though, I duck into one of the many shops in the Magic Kingdom. I walk to the back and surround myself with Mickey and Minnie Mouse dolls, where I can keep an eye on him. Sooner or later, he will move away, and when he does, I will find out what's behind that fence. Damn it! I thought if I waited long enough, he would move to another spot, but when he did, another employee just took his place. I don't want to be seen hanging around, or he might get suspicious. So I buy an overpriced Donald Duck keychain as I continue to walk around the shops, keeping an eye out for any opening I can exploit. My patience is starting to wear thin when I finally seize an opportunity. They do try to tell people about the Florida heat, but every day at least one guest decides to ignore the warnings and not drink enough fluids. It was an elderly man this time. I saw him collapse on the ground nearby as the rest of his family just stood over him in shock, dumbfounded by his collapse. I must admit to being impressed by the employee. I watch as he quickly comes over and starts to assist the gentleman, simultaneously calling for help while rendering aid. I'm not going to get another shot at this. So, I take a deep breath and walk past the group dealing with the emergency. I bury myself into the bushes as I make my way through the fence. It doesn't take long for me to find the gate again. I grab the handle and find it opening easily as I quietly sneak in. The door to the right swung open with no sound and no resistance as I enter and close it behind me. It takes me a moment to realize just how quiet it is. Behind me, I could still hear music and the chaos of thousands of people going from ride to ride. But somehow, it all sounds miles away. The continuous scraping of my shoes against the concrete as I walk onwards is the only sound I make. The My Little Pony ride looks impressive, and I feel the little girl inside of me giggle at it in awe. The outside was made to look like a giant tree, with an opening at its base for guests to enter. From its many branches, I could see colorful figures of ponies staring at me through the leaves, or playing around the trunk of the tree near the opening. I feel a little creeped out. Their stares are too intense, and their smiles too wide, like they're masking an ulterior motive beneath the cheery facade. A I take a deep breath as I feel myself growing more anxious. My mind wanders to that little girl from earlier. Her smile is stuck in my head, and the similarities it has to the pony statues are uncanny. I work my way through some old rusted barriers, and somewhere in the distance I can hear the hum of engines. Was the ride somehow left on? Flickering lights made to look like candles illuminate the inside as I approach it. The room is circular and made out of plastic that has been constructed to look like wood. Rows upon rows of dusted books are glued onto old shelves, rotting away and covered in cobwebs. In the center was a large puddle of green water, probably algae. Rainwater must have leaked in from the hole in the roof and formed a puddle in the middle of the room. This place reminds me more of the Haunted Mansion ride than a cheerful cartoon of singing ponies. On one wall, a screen was built into the fake wood. It had been warped and scratched with a thin film of grime from the looks of it. Was it even going to play? I couldn't tell you as the things looked pretty damaged. I imagined that I could hear the voices of thousands of people waiting patiently in the line alongside their children. The voices follow me as I make my way through the room and to the other side, which led me down a corridor made of the same plastic wood. Occasionally, I would pass more empty monitors attached to the ceiling. A couple have fallen off their posts to shatter on the ground. Isn't that alone too risky of a design choice? I pass another room, easily stepping around the tarnished and stained brass rails separating the lines of people that would never use it. And still, this sensation of being surrounded seems to follow me as I walk into the third and final room. This room was bigger than the other two, as it divided people into yet more lines. Beyond it was a mural of a forest overlooking a clear blue sky, with the silhouette of a castle in the background. In the center was a metal track painted black, with a gold chariot sitting on it, humming quietly from the unseen motors running below the rails, patiently waiting for me to get on. Each seat had a harness that rose above it. A symbol of a sun was painted on the front of the chariot. On the side was the numbers 101010. For 2 years, it sat here neglected, yet the chariot seemed brand new, the seat comfortable. I second-guessed myself on whether or not I should even get in, but there was no going back. I know I have to see this to the end. I continue to feel the unseen eyes watching me as I step downward into the chariot and make my way towards the middle. The harness suddenly comes down over me, securing me with a loud click as the ride begins to move and a hidden door in front of me opens.
Here in Equestria, our magic can be unpredictable to creatures such as you,
said the voice overhead as the chariot rolled onward.
So please keep your hands, feet, and head inside the chariot at all times.
And please, no flash photography during your trip. It could scare all those cute, cuddly animals of the forest, and we wouldn't want that now, would we?
Said another voice before the chariot began to accelerate. I'm surprised of the condition of the ride. Despite having a couple years of neglect, it still runs pretty smoothly, except with the exception of some animatronics not working properly and some damaged screens. The chariot zips along the rails, following a purple unicorn named Twilight Sparkle, who continued to take me all over Equestria, showing off all of her friends that lived in Ponyville. I'm about halfway through the ride when I notice things take a sharp and dark turn. Clouds begin to fill the screen above me, and it gets noticeably darker. Lightning flashes all around me as an ominous laughter was heard growing louder and louder.
Oh no! Nightmare Moon is back!
Yelled Twilight Sparkle. A silhouette of something dark drifts behind the cartoon clouds. Something that I was sure didn't belong in the ride. my anxiety flares up again when I get that unmistakable feeling that something is wrong. My hands grip the harness, and I pull it to see if I could lift it up, but it's locked firmly in place. Another flash of lightning rips the darkness apart, as black ooze begins to pour out of the animatronics. The blackness drips downwards, tearing up the ponies as it seeps into the ground, exposing their metallic insides.
"You wanted to know, Melanie,"
said the remains of Twilight, as her face sunk into her head, twisting into a terrible grin before dropping to the ground.
"You wanted to see. You wanted to understand what we are. I hope you enjoy the ride."
The chariot rocketed forward, going faster until turning sharply downwards, as I feel myself being pressured into the seat from acceleration. Downwards I shoot, everything becoming a blur of motion.
"He is at the center. He is the everything. He is the
end.
The eater. The chaos. He is
everything.
And he is hungry. Always hungry.
And we are eating. Always eating.
Behold the chaos. Hail the eater."
A reddish light rips the darkness apart, and I saw. I didn't want to see, but I couldn't stop. A thing beyond imagination of any sane or rational mind lay there, unmoving. Even though I was still a distance away, the size of the thing was incomprehensible.
"As big as the world. Maybe even bigger,"
whispered a voice in my ear as I sat there, unable to move, my terror paralyzing me. Its worm-like body was black without eyes, ears, or nose. Only a mouth moved to expose rows upon rows of mountain-sized teeth. On the side, I saw deformed wings and misshapen limbs too small for such a huge creature to use. I didn't want to see it. I just wanted it all to stop. But as I looked onward, I knew that name. From the deepest corner of my soul, I knew it. Discord. Certain that that's what it called itself, as I'm certain as the sky is blue. It was immense. It was terrifying. And it was dead. I gagged as I caught the overpowering stench of rotten decay. The creature was decomposing. I stared at things resembling deformed ticks, the size of houses, crawling all over the corpse by the millions. Their abdomen swollen to the point of bursting as they consumed the dead monster worm. I stared as one of the eaters loses its footing on the carcass, tumbling downwards and hits the floor in bursts, spilling enough black goo to fill a few pools. Still, my terror grows. There must be about 10 of them crawling around the mess on the ground. They're crying in pain as they start to evaporate, their bodies twisting and turning from the exposure to the elements. All I can think is, oh my god, they look like ponies. And then, the true horror hits me. All of it. The truth of it all. The knowing of the unknown. Discord isn't dead.
"Ding, ding, ding. Give the lady a prize."
"He is, but he isn't. Discord is somehow in between. Living in the dead, but still clinging to life. It was growing and it was coming back, and it knew I was here." The chariot banked sharply, speeding towards the it. Faster and faster it goes, and I can see its mouth growing bigger. I can only think of one thing, though. To try and get off of this chariot. Maybe then I have a fighting chance of being able to avoid the impending doom that awaits me at the end of this line. My panic takes over as I blindly fight against the restraints. As horrible as the thought of death can be, I knew that it would be nothing compared to what was inside the thing waiting for me. And still, the chariot continued on.
You wanted to know. You wanted to see. Just know you will always have friends to be with you. Forever. Isn't it magical?
Its teeth hung overhead as I shoot into its mouth, into the darkness. It's then that everything snaps inside of me. And I do the only thing I can do. I scream.
Were able to defeat Nightmare Moon and restore Equestria,
says a white alicorn as the chariot passes by her.
Now I will safely send you back to the Magic Kingdom, but do feel free to visit whenever you'd like. There's always time for new friends.
I sat there in stunned silence, unable to comprehend anything that had just happened. I blankly watched rows of dancing ponies, celebrating the defeat of Nightmare Moon.
Farewell, new friends! I hope to see you again real soon!
Screams a pink pony standing on the edge of the top of the exit doors as she brings out a cannon that showers me with degraded confetti. I feel the ride roll to a complete stop back at the beginning. My body starts to shake and convulse as everything rips through me. For the first time in my life, I believe in true evil. For the first time in my life, I believe in the devil. I feel bile rushing up, and the harness mercifully unhooks me, giving me the freedom to finally get out. I vomit. I cry. I vomit some more. How I got away, I couldn't tell you, as everything is a blur. I don't know how I got up from the Magic Kingdom and made it to my car. But once there, I finally felt safe. It took me a while to get myself under control before I turned the keys in the ignition and let the AC cool me off. As I put my car into drive, I noticed something sticking out from the side of the passenger seat. As I laid it on my lap, I felt the fear return. It was a laminated folder covered in Disney characters with the word memories printed on it in bright gold letters and a red border. Opening it up, I saw a photo of myself on that damn ride. I thought I rode alone, but there was someone sitting behind me. That little girl wearing the yellow dress and the pink hair. Her eyes were blacked out, smiling and waving at the camera. At the bottom, inscribed in the picture, was a phrase, "Abandoned by God."